Subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to press the bell icon to get all the latest updates.
In December 2017, construction for a 2.5 km flyover was started in Koramangala. In the nearly 4 years that has passed since, not only has the flyover missed multiple deadlines for its completion, but it has absolutely disrupted the life of one family in Bengaluru.
I'm Lawrence A. I had my accident on 6th of December 2019 when I was heading towards my store in Kantaspura, CV Ramnagar. I don't know really what it fell on me or something after some of them gave the narration saying that it was an hydraulic bolt which has a 52 kg of weight fallen from the height of 110 feet. So this has fallen onto my head, that is my helmet. I was wearing an helmet which has been broken. I have 5 stitches here, and from there it has fallen onto my shoulder, where my shoulder has been broken, and it has hit my ribs, and 6 ribs were broken, and I was taken to St. John's Hospital nearby. And if I see my emergency report, my lungs were profusely bleeding, so because of this ribs were broken. So from there, they were treating for me to thin the blood. Meanwhile, I had an heart attack.
I'm Janet Lawrence. I got a call at 5 o'clock from his manager saying that he has been into an accident and he is in St. John's Hospital. Me and my son rushed to hospital, but we thought it is a maybe minor accident. On the way, when we reached Forum, we got a message that he is in a very critical condition, come fast. When we reached the hospital, only we came to know, even the doctor said there is no hope. There is no hope in him because he is in a very critical condition. After that, doctor told me he got a heart attack. I was so much worried where I can put my son, then how I will manage. His friends and family members were there to support us.
I was there in St. John's Hospital for the whole month. 31st of December, I got discharged. I was on waterbed for several months, and physio started in the month last year, and it is still going on. And I have to approach many doctors for physio and for my orthopedic part of it. One second thing, I have to take n number of tablets because I have to take for my BP, my thin blood being, my heart, for my uric acid, which was all these things came, and I have to lose even my teeth, which is already broken now. And what to say, with this accident, I've lost not only my physical health, my mentally, and have so much of agony and turmoil, which is building up because my son is so small. Now he has gone to 5th standard. When I had my accident, he was in 3rd standard. Now we have to compromise with so many things, not only health, not only the money part of it, the happiness which we had at home. Every time now he says that, Dada, you are sick, Mama is sick. So it gives so much of agony.
First day BBMB came and said to us they will take care of everything. That is the way. After third day we went to BBMB office and met the commissioner. And they said, we will do the compensation very soon, don't be worried, we will take care of everything. So from the hospital, each time they used to call us, come, there is a meeting. And I used to run. Pillar to pillar, I was running with all the documents. But there was nothing. After discharge, they changed their complete character. They washed their hands.
On 20th of January 2020, point blank, they said that they are not responsible for it. We will meet you in court legally. So we were just waiting because we don't have any kind of source or money to fight the legal battle. We waited, and afterwards a few of my friends with their help, we had hired a lawyer. He's did with the High Court. We filed the court case, and afterwards what had happened is that the verdict came in the month of December last year, saying that since the advocate was not able to attend because of this pandemic, this is an online one. So the verdict was said that you can approach any appropriate forum to get your compensation. Now we have filed it in the civil court and the trial court is running on. And as per our advocate's recent update, that he has spoken with the Simplex and they are stating now that we will be able to pay only if there is going to be a court verdict or BBMP has to give us the direction to pay the compensation. BBMP just blames the Simplex that they have given the contract to them. Here it's very clear that both of them are not giving us any stand, or they are giving clarity that who will be paying us, when they will be paying us, how much long it will take, and the justice is getting delayed.
Since the accident, how have both of you been managing your finances and paying for medical bills?
Basically, to tell you very clearly, she has lost her job. I don't have a job to go about. And now what is happening is that people are helping us, family members, friends. We are very considerate. We have 18,000 rupees which has to be paid for the physio and around 10 to 12,000 rupees which runs for my medicine. And still that for the family maintenance, you people must be knowing, you have to pay rent, electricity and other things. My son's education also is there. So it's the beginning of the year. Then my son has to be educated. Everything is due, everything is put to halt.
So tell me a little bit about how COVID has affected your family.
Yes, we had gone through this stage also. As a family, we had it. And still we are recovering. So it has come to my wife as well as to me. And to my son also here, because we don't have a very palatial house. It is a 1 BHK where we all have to live under the same roof. Much to worry is that about my health condition, what it is. And we are uncertain how it's going to take us. The whole future is doomed.
As Lawrence and his family struggle to make ends meet, BBMP and Simplex seem to show no concern for a family whose life has been disrupted due to their negligence. This is Vaishnavi Suresh and you're watching Mojo Stories.
It's great to see you here. Thank you for watching our work. If you haven't subscribed yet, don't forget to click the bell icon and subscribe to Mojo Story and support independent, robust journalism.